thinker, a free thinker. And so this is why you and your remarks is kind of solidifying that, because you said, we're in Bible study now, right? Knowing that we really wasn't, and that wasn't a question that you was actually looking for an answer to. That was a question. That was a loaded question with sarcasm.
No, right? It wasn't sarcasm, because I
that's exactly
know
what it was. You didn't want to answer for that because you knew we wasn't in Bible study.
No, I did not. I didn't know what the forum was about. That's why I asked.
I sent you the link to the forum. It has a title to it.
Oh, okay. And I know you're going to bash me because I didn't read it. I just joined as soon as I came out because I didn't want to be too late.
Listen to the words. So I want you guys to pay attention to the words that she's using, right? And this is why I pay attention to what people say, right? She said, I'm going to bash her. Okay, so what exactly have I stated that's actually bashing you? I told you what your belief was because you didn't know.
Corrected, because guess what? Only a fool knows everything. So I don't know anything in this forum right now, we're going to have a conversation.
You're jumping. You're avoiding my questions, right?
Okay.
See, you're not staying on one focal point. And people do that when they don't want the center of attention on them. See, I'm trying to establish a focal point and address everything that you're saying, but you keep tap dancing around it. Okay. So now you said I was bashing you. So I gave
now
you
I'm Fred Astaire. Story. I'm Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. I'm tap dancing.
Okay. So I asked you a question. Give me an example of how you've been bashed, because you say now I'm going to bash you.
No, I'm saying let's start over from the beginning. So this is about relationship. Is there a male hierarchy? So can you explain to me from the Bible or the Torah that God is first a male hierarchy?
All right. So
as opposed to being
briefly, can I interject briefly?
Yeah, go ahead, sis. Go ahead, sis.
For me, he literally asked your opinion, right? Right. And I haven't heard you answer that yet. He said, do you believe in the Most High? You of said, course. Absolutely. Then he said, do you believe in the hierarchy? And then it went left. But it was kind of simple. Either yes, you do believe in it, or no, you don't. So me personally, I just want to know, do you believe in that or no, to answer the question. So that way we can progress forward instead of going off.
All right. So what is the hierarchy according to you, what you're telling me it is? Because it may be different in my mind from what you're saying. So if you tell me in a way of understanding what the hierarchy is as a male figure hierarchy in the Most High, then I can answer with the right answer.
So the appropriate term is that the Most High created a patriarch. Right. So that should clarify it and leave any skepticism out of your mind. So when the Most High created the earth, he created a patriarch. Right.
Right.
When you read the Bible, it's obvious that he was dealing with a patriarch.
Okay.
So Kadar, can you get that precept 2:15? Oh. Bereshit 2:15.
Book of Bereshit, Genesis chapter 2, verse 15. And Yahuwah, the supreme power, took the man and put him into the garden in Eden to dress it and to keep it.
Okay, stop. So it says, so a lot of Christians like to come along when they read the Bible, they trying to say when it says man, that it was talking about the entire human race. No, it wasn't.
Okay.
The word ish is a specific male gender in the Ibrit, right? Isha is the female gender, right? Ish means male or husband. Isha means female or wife, right? So, or Adam, what they would like to interpret, they said, well, he didn't, a guy was arguing with, well, he tried to argue with me in the park about Adam didn't have a gender, right? He didn't have a gender. He said Adam was male and female, and then later on, he became male. Well, it absolutely makes no sense. Okay. I'm talking about full-grown Adam, right? So from right here, it's telling us that he placed a man in the garden and he told man to dress the garden. So it was man that actually named all the creatures, not the Most High. He put that on man. Adam gave names to everything. And then after Adam did that, the Most High was done, and he said, it's not good that man should be alone. I will create a woman for him, a help meet for him, to help him to carry out his will. So it suffice to say that Adam was like the Most High's vice gerent, because he created man as a god to rule in his absence. Since he's not in the earth, he created man to rule in the earth. And so that's why he created a hierarchy. So the hierarchy is, we'll use the terms that you use, God the Father, God the Son, man, woman, then children. Then everything else is subservient to that. Like these public officials, everything else is subservient to that. But that's the divine order. And so the proof is in the pudding. Now that the world has decided to go against that order, the world is chaotic. You have more crime than ever before. You have more abortions than ever before. You have more murders than ever before. You have like people on drugs. Why? Because the Most High created the most man to be a covering of his family, to be a protector and a covering for his family. And so the way to disrupt that is to remove the man. And this is what's happened. So women that say, well, I don't need the man, I could do it alone, she's miserably fell when it comes to trying to rear children alone. She's fell. It's been proven again and again. I'm an example because I've been a single father for 8-9 years. I raised my sons way better than their mother could have. They was being abused. They was being neglected. Julio's another example, right? And it's been proven again and again statistically, children that come from single parent homes where the parent is a father, those children do just as well as homes where they have both parents. But you can't say that for females. And society doesn't want to push that. But society knows that, but they won't say it.
Okay. But my question is, like, whose fault is that?
Your fault.
No, that's not
it. It is.
Okay, so if you're in a relationship, it doesn't work out, or suppose you lose your mate and you're subject to raising your child by yourself, why should that be? You didn't cause that to happen.
Yeah, you did.
So if your mate died, just I'm saying.
Different. A widow is different. The relationships that I'm talking about don't come from widows. The percentage of widows that exist in the world is very, very low. Very, very low. And the reason that I'm saying it's your fault, if you look at the divorce statistics, who's initiating the divorces?
It's more women than